Often, when a flurfer asks how the circumference of the Earth was found, you will hear a global answer: Eratosthenes did it around 200 BC. The standard reaction of a flurfer will be: there is no proof that Eratosthenes ever even existed, and his so-called method with the two sticks has not been described by him, that is, there are no written accounts of it. And, by the way, his method works just as well on a flat earth. This last statement, of course, is a blatant lie, but nevertheless, the rest of their arguments are somewhat valid. I often wondered whether or not there would be more ancient people having calculated the circumference of the earth. And there is one, whose existence cannot be debated and whose scriptures have been preserved. That one is the mathematician from India, Aryabhatta, who lived from 476 to 550 AD. He was a most famous mathematician who worked on the approximation of pi. He knew the sine for zero. His knowledge of trigonometry was vast. His sine tables were famous. He worked on indeterminate equations. He was a master in algebra and has worked extensively on astronomy. He insisted that the Earth rotates around its axis daily, something that was not generally accepted in those days. He described the motions of the solar system. He explained eclipses. He calculated the sidereal rotation of the Earth to an accuracy of around 0.01 second, and the length of the sidereal year with an accuracy of only 3 minutes and 20 seconds. In his book Aryabhatiya, he describes an interesting way to calculate the circumference of the Earth. He found two points A and B on the same latitude and calculated the terrestrial distance between them and at that latitude. Using the time difference between similar astronomical observations at A and B, he could have calculated the circumference of the latitudinal circle using his formula that 1 degree rotation represents 4 minutes time difference. From this, he could have used this sine table to calculate the equatorial circumference. This is a different approach than Eratosthenes did. I wondered if we can replicate this method using modern-day data, and it worked. First, I selected a few cities near the equator. The first two were Libreville in Gabon and Kampala in Uganda, lying at 0.39 and 0.35 degrees latitude respectively. The time difference between solar noon at the 20 March equinox at both places was 92 minutes. The distance between them was 2,572.32 kilometers. 92 minutes represent 23 degrees rotation, so the circumference at around 0.36 degrees latitude can be calculated to be 40,262.40 kilometers. Using trigonometry, we can calculate the circumference at the equator to be 40,265.23 kilometers. The generally accepted circumference at the equator is 40,008 kilometers. The calculation, therefore, is 0.64% off. I made the same calculations using Macapá in Brazil and Entebbe in Uganda and came up with a circumference at the equator of 40,040.55 kilometers, a value that was only 0.08% off. These cities all lie in different time zones, which makes establishing the exact time of solar noon on every city a bit difficult and possibly a bit inaccurate. So I made the calculations again at a much higher latitude with three cities in the same time zone. First, Utrecht, the Netherlands, and Ahaus in Germany, at 52.09 and 52.08 degrees latitude, respectively. The circumference of the Earth at the equator was calculated to be 37,732.63 kilometers. This was 5.69% off. This is probably because the solar noon times are rounded off. The time difference is given at 8 minutes, but in reality it is 7.635 minutes. At greater distances, this rounding error has less influence, so my last calculations was between Utrecht, the Netherlands, and Warsaw in Poland at 52.09 and 52.23 degrees latitude respectively. In that case, the circumference of the Earth at the equator came out to be 39,667.27 kilometers, a value that is 0.85% off. So the method Aryabhata seems to work perfectly fine using modern day data. There are, however, two important presumptions for it to work. The Earth is a perfect ball, and the Earth rotates around its axis in 24 hours. So, the $60,000 question is, would the method work on a flat Earth with the presumptions the Earth is a flat plane, the Earth doesn't move, the Sun revolves around a point on the Earth at a trajectory straight above the equator at the equinox. As far as I'm concerned, it doesn't matter whether the Sun is a physical object or just a light or even a projection in the sky. It also doesn't matter how high in the sky the Sun is observed. The fact is that it looks like the Sun is moving through the sky in such a way that it is back at around his position after 24 hours. It's the observation of the Sun that plays a role here. The whole calculation is done on a flat plane. The latitude is generally given in degrees. However, this is a unit that only makes sense in a globe Earth. On a flat plane, the value of the latitude can be considered as a linear measurement. Around the equator, everything still is fine and dandy. The calculated circumference of the equator is only 1.73% off for Libreville, Kampala, and 9.57% off for Macapá and Entebbe. The first calculation is almost spot on. That is because the length of the straight line between those two cities is almost the same as the curved line at the equator. The difference between the first and the second calculation is caused by the greater distance between the cities. The length of the straight line is considerably shorter than the curved line, resulting in a longer equator. When we perform the calculation at a much higher latitude, the differences become unacceptable. A deviation of 37.58% for Utrecht Aarhus and of 45.14% for Utrecht Warsaw are off the chart. This deviation is partly caused by the difference in length between the straight line between the cities and the curved line of the equator. But most of the difference is caused by the fact that the longitude lines converge to the center point of the equator, which makes the straight line much shorter than the real distance, leading to the calculations of a far too large radius. But the most devastating result of these calculations is that the resulting circumferences all are different, getting larger the higher in latitude the cities are situated. I could make calculations of the resulting heights of the Sun in relation to the given altitudes of the Sun as presented in timeanddate.com. I won't. Anyone can see that these calculations will have an equally disastrous outcome as the calculations I did present. And there it is. The Earth cannot be flat. Aryabhata has shown it not to be in the 5th century.